I'm Katarzyna Szymielewicz. I work at Panoptykon Foundation, where we investigate how data can be used to influence people and how we, the people, can fight back. I'm here to explain what sort of knowledge about you can be generated by machine learning algorithms. We are talking about the type of artificial intelligence that is designed and controlled by technological companies in order to influence human behavior. These algorithms make decisions about you, and they do it every day, often without us even knowing. It usually happens behind the screen without bothering us in a very smooth and efficient manner. Algorithmic decisions can be very trivial, but in the age of surveillance capitalism, they tend to gain gravity. Think of traffic lights that change when you approach the street, or about personal newsfeed that is shown in your social media, or equally personalized prices for flights that you will be shown next time you search for one. It is also algorithms that assist real people in deciding whether you qualify for a mortgage, whether you can enroll at a particular university, or whether you qualify for insurance. But how do they get all that information to inform these decisions? Well, it's all based on data, your data, to be more precise, on your digital profile. Everyone has a digital profile, and it usually has three layers. The first layer is the one we control ourselves. It is information that we give when we use computers, phones, and everything else connected to the internet. Your username, your real name, your contacts, friends, but also people you have blocked from your contact list, your photos, everything you upload or consciously share with others. In most cases, you can choose not to share it, but in reality, even that part gets complicated if you just want to live part of your life online and be spontaneous in that life. Bad news is that even if you manage to control the first layer, there are still two more that are incredibly difficult to control. By the mere fact of being online and doing things online, you are sharing a lot more information than you think. The second layer in your digital profile includes metadata and traces of everything you do online. Think of your current location, of the sites you visit, but even things like how you type and how many mistakes you make while typing. There is also a record of any connected activity. If you've got a smart fridge, it remembers that you held the door open for 3 minutes in the middle of the night for that midnight snack. It is nearly impossible to prevent that type of data being collected about you. You cannot opt out from that constant behavioral observation. Where is the third layer? What more algorithms can learn about us after they've observed every move, every step we make online? They can learn more by comparing our behavior with patterns they have observed when looking at the behavior of all other people. Machines make assumptions and predictions about us based on statistical data. It uses all the prior knowledge collected about you from your own data and observations about people to make predictions about things like who you might vote for, whether you have any vulnerability like a mental illness, or whether you might be expecting a baby. It is this third layer of your profile called inferred data that has most value for companies. On that basis, they make their choices with regards to what advertising you should be watching and how your newsfeed should be shaped. It's pretty much impossible for you to control that layer. In fact, you cannot even discover what these machines think about you. So what does AI really know about you? Way more than you think. Any good news? Well, there are people starting to do things about it so that you can regain control over your information. At Panoptykon, we are making sure that there are legal safeguards in place to protect us, and that legal actions against data-hungry companies result in high fines. Mozilla is rethinking how our data is collected and used altogether. It is a long march, but we are heading in the right direction.